Like, I'm not mad at it, but it's not my best friend. Why do I have a story for every single item? I don't know. Rose, and welcome back to Cheap Lazy Vegan and another video. Today, guys, I decided to film a random grocery haul because I went grocery shopping. I actually went grocery shopping to buy ingredients for other videos, and I thought, hey, why not show you guys what I got? Because I know you guys used to love my grocery hauls. I used to do grocery hauls all the time when I first started this channel, and they were some of my most popular videos. I say this every grocery haul because it still kind of like amazes me that so many people wanted to see what I buy for my groceries. But anyways, I thought I would continue and go down memory lane and show you guys what I got. I got a few different things. I went to Superstore. For those of you guys that live in Canada, you probably know where that is. It's a big grocery store. It's pretty budget friendly compared to like Safeway or Co-op. So I actually like walk there, and I walk there so I can get extra exercise and plus save a little money because Safeway is not cheap. So I'm gonna show you guys what I got. It's kind of random, but still I think this could be potentially helpful for those of you that are starting out on a plant-based diet. This might give you some ideas. I'm gonna try to sprinkle in some tips here and there. By the way, if you want more grocery hauls, I do have a playlist of all my grocery hauls from my past. So I'll link that down below if you guys are interested. Okay, so let's get started. All right, so let's get started with whatever is closest to me. So this is kind of miscellaneous. So the first thing I have is two giant bottles of Frank's Red Hot Sauce. Yes, my friends, I bought two giant bottles, mainly for a video, but when I have Frank's Hot Sauce in my possession, I use it a lot. It tastes good, what can I say? It's basically just red peppers, vinegar, water, salt, and garlic powder. It's really not bad. I mean, it's probably really salty, but you know what? It's okay. So I bought two because they had like two for $10 or something, and one bottle was like $8. I was like, I'm gonna get two. When you are buying groceries and you know you're gonna eventually use up and you can keep it like, you know, in your pantry and it won't go bad, buy it in bulk if you have the space because usually it's cheaper. Second thing is very random. Well, it's not random, but it's like, everyone should have this, and I just ran out of it. It's baking soda. So I ran out of baking soda because I realized that it is usable for everything. You just have to have baking soda and white vinegar in your home at all times, because whatever thing that you need to do, like unclogging your drain or fixing your burnt pot, yes, these are two things I had to do recently. Apparently, baking soda and vinegar fixes all of your problems. And of course, you can bake with baking soda, yes. This is not really in any order. So next item, of course you guys, I have to have edamame beans. So this is like a staple in my freezer. I buy bags like this. These are the ones that are shelled. So that means it's already taken out of the shell. Okay, that's what shelled means. I got the President's Choice, which is the Superstore brand, I believe. Edamame beans, this is perfect for everything. I have it as a snack if I want like something, you know, really simple, high protein snack. It's good to add into your meals. For half a cup, it's 90 calories and it's 9 grams of protein. It's really good. I love the taste of it. I just can't get enough, okay? Everyone should have one of these in their freezer. It's so convenient. I can't, it's great. And this whole bag was $3, I think, and you get 500 grams. It's pretty good. One of these bags will last you a while, so I highly recommend getting some edamame beans. Next thing I got, I don't buy vegan yogurts very often. I don't know what it is. I don't know. Even when I ate dairy, I don't think I had that much yogurt. I don't remember, okay? But I do like yogurt, so that's another thing. I do like yogurt. I just don't really buy a lot of it. But this brand, I believe, is pretty good. Now, I got their natural plain kind. So this is the Maison Riviera. Okay, Maison Riviera. Is this Canadian? I don't know. Yes, it's from Quebec, okay? So this, I tried, I think their mango flavor or something. That was really good. I really enjoyed whatever I tried from this brand. You know what, let's try it. Why not? Let's make this a taste test. This one's the plain kind. Ooh, well, that's great. Let's just wipe it off. No big deal. Hold on, this one is unsweetened. It does smell yogurty. Let's see. It's promising. It does have a little bit of a weird taste. Apparently this is oat-based yogurt. It has a little bit of that weird taste that you get with unsweetened yogurts. But I feel like you could just easily fix it by adding in a little bit of sweetener and maybe some like fruit and stuff. Like, I'm not mad at it, but it's not my best friend, okay? I bought it because I like the macros, okay? So I was looking at this one and like a flavored one, and the flavored one was like double the calories and like the same amount of protein. And I like the fact that this is, for 3/4 cup, it's 60 calories and 5 grams of protein. I think that's pretty good. I was basically trying to look for kind of like a vegan Greek yogurt type of situation. But yeah, I think you can make this happen. I think this could happen, okay? It can happen. So there's that at Maison Riviera. Their sweetened ones are really good, okay? But this one's the unsweetened one. So it's not, you know, it's not the best, but it's better for you. All right, guys, let's move on to canned items that are in front of me. So of course, guys, I have my must-have item. Like, I actually get anxiety if I don't have this in my pantry, is chickpeas, okay? I need at least one can of chickpeas in my pantry at all times. I prefer to have two or more just to, you know, calm me down. So I actually found this. It's funny. Why do I have a story for every single item? I don't know. So I found this in the kind of Indian food section of the grocery store. But then there's also a different section where there's like beans, I guess not from India. Okay, this is a lot cheaper. Okay, so this one is Tamam brand. This can is 796, so almost 800 milliliters. And I think a standard can of chickpeas is about 400 milliliters, so it's about half. And this whole thing was only $1. Okay, this whole can. Whereas the other one, it was $1 for a small can. And usually it's a little bit more than $1. So this was a steal. I don't know why I didn't buy more. I think I just didn't want to carry more. So yeah, this is $1 for a can, a really big can of chickpeas. Really good to have around. Cans of beans are always just a must to have in your pantry. Chickpeas are just my favorite type of bean. I mean, other than edamame beans. Go to the Indian section for cheaper beans, okay? And also probably cheaper lentils and stuff like that. Next, I have 2 cans of baked beans from Heinz, okay? So I have the original Heinz in tomato sauce. With baked beans, always make sure you check the ingredients list because sometimes they'll add in like, I don't know, some kind of animal ingredient, okay? But the Heinz tomato sauce one is vegan friendly. And these are just convenient. I'm gonna again do a video featuring these little guys. And these are convenient to have because they're already like flavored, so it's an easy way to eat beans. It's probably not the best for you because there's like a lot going on, but it's probably not the worst for you. I don't know. Next product I will show you. I got these crispy minis. Basically what are these called? Rice cakes. I got brown rice cakes. These just make a good snack if you just wanna, you know, put stuff on them. Rice cakes. This is just brown rice. Apparently the only ingredient is whole grain brown rice. So that's pretty, that's good. Yeah, it's just kind of like a convenient good snack. Spread some hummus on there. You're good to go. Next thing I got was a French loaf baked in store. And it's a loaf of bread. This, you guys, was only $1. $1. I know, very cheap, really nice French loaf. The only thing is that you'll probably want to slice these up and put them in the freezer if you're not going to eat them in the next like couple of days, because they will probably harden. Gotta love a big loaf. So next, I also got some soft tortillas. So these would be great for tacos, quesadillas, fajitas, all the goodness. I do like to have these around. They make a really good snack if you don't want like a full wrap. Yeah, Old El Paso. Next, I have a random thing that I'm trying. This is Melba canapé, bruschetta flavor. Again, good snack. So this one, yeah, I just kind of like looked at the, you know, cracker section. Oh, one side note for those of you that are, you know, wondering, because I know this was a question that I was asking when I first started, you know, plant-based eating. When an ingredients list says may contain milk, it doesn't actually contain milk. It actually means it doesn't contain milk, but it's produced in a facility that may also produce other products that may have milk. It's just mainly for allergies and cross-contamination. But when it says like may contain and it's not in the actual ingredients list, then it's pretty much vegan. That's basically what I wanted to say. So yeah, that's one thing that I think a lot of beginners get confused with. When it says may contain, you're good. If it says contains milk, obviously that means it contains milk. May contain is just an allergy notification. As long as it doesn't say milk in the ingredients list, it's vegan. Okay, well, I mean, check for other things too, but you know what I mean, okay? This could be good for snacks. Yes. Okay, now let's go through the produce. Very exciting, I know. 3 bananas. I am really not big on bananas, but I do like to put them on smoothies. on smoothies, in smoothies. English. I also got two oranges. Oranges are better than apples. I think I like oranges better than apples. I think I do. I mean, it depends. It depends on the apple, it depends on the orange, but I really like oranges. They're very refreshing. So I got two. Probably gonna eat one as a snack later. I got some baby carrots, of course. Very convenient little snack. I also got some red peppers, another convenient little snack. I also got some baby bok choy. You guys know I love baby bok choy. I always buy baby bok choy. I like to eat it fresh, cooked, throw it into soups, salads, whatever I want. So good. Next, I have some celery. I'm not a big celery person either, but I'm doing a video. So I got celery. I mean, I don't mind celery. I just don't really find myself buying it a lot. And every time I do, it just kind of like sits there a little bit longer than it should. So, but it's good for you. Okay? So next, of course, this is probably one of my favorite vegetables other than baby bok choy. Broccoli. Love me some broccoli. This is probably gonna last me a week. Maybe not even. Maybe a couple days. Who knows? Okay, broccoli. Must have. Must have. Next, I got a zucchini. Self-explanatory. It's a zucchini. Why am I talking so much for a very relatively small grocery haul? So last few things, these are kind of what I would qualify as like vegan products, as in they're kind of like marketed toward vegans or people that follow a plant-based diet. So they do tend to be a little bit more expensive. You don't need them in your diet, absolutely not, but I bought them for another video because I'm going to be doing a kind of overview of some of my favorite alternatives. So these would be considered alternatives. Now you don't need these in your diet to have a delicious, fulfilling, healthy, plant-based diet. These are just very convenient options that tend to be more expensive and they tend to be not as healthy. But I do like to have a few of these around to sprinkle in some convenience. So I'll just show you guys what I got. I got these Eve's veggie burgers. So this is the family pack because it was cheaper, once again. I'm gonna keep these in my freezer and once in a while, if I want a quick veggie burger, I'll take it out. I like these because they're not so intimidatingly large like the Beyond Burger. I like the Beyond Burger. That's my favorite in terms of taste, but it's A, very expensive, and B, I feel like, you know, if I eat out, I'm gonna eat a Beyond Burger usually. So I don't need to have it in my house as well. So usually I don't really buy Beyond Burgers that much, at least not at home. These are just a lot more like approachable. It's only 100 calories per burger patty, so you can have two and it's not crazy. And I really like the protein in this. It's 13 grams of protein per patty, so 100 calories for 13 grams of protein. I think that's pretty good, and they taste pretty good. Like I don't mind them at all, so I like them. And there's literally 8 in here, and I think it cost, how much did this cost? Oh, I should have got two. It was two for $15 and one for 8. I could have saved a dollar. Anyway, either way, it was $8 for all days, okay? Whereas a Beyond Burger, literally it's $8 for two patties at the grocery store. Whereas this is $8 for 8 patties. Granted, these are not as big, so you'll probably need to eat two of these. Still, 8 patties. So that's that. That's the Eve's veggie burger. Next, I also got some maple bacon flavor tempeh. I love tempeh, great source of protein. This one is 150 calories for 7 slices and 15 grams of protein. It's a great source of protein. I love the maple bacon flavor, bacon maple flavor, whatever you want to call it. This one is the President's Choice kind. So it's a little cheaper than, I believe, what's the other brand, like Tofurky or something. This one's like a little bit cheaper and I think it tastes kind of the same. So it's all good. And once again, if I don't eat it all, I can keep it in the freezer and I can take it out and thaw it and cook it. So it's really convenient. This is nice and smoky. I put it into sandwiches, you know, on the side of my breakfast, in a stir fry, do whatever you want. So tempeh, really good. Last but not least, so we have two Gardein products. These are definitely more on the kind of luxury side of things, okay? Things that I don't eat regularly, but once in a while, it's a nice treat. I got these turkey cutlets. I've tried these before, I believe, like last Christmas maybe, and I think they were really good, if my memory serves me correctly. Honestly, most Gardein products are really good, especially they're like breaded stuff. I mean, it's just like breaded, fried. Of course it's gonna be good, you know? Speaking of Gardein, I have another Gardein product. This one is definitely like something that it stands out to me. This is the Crabless Cakes, fish-free Crabless Cakes. I tried it, I think once, I bought it once, maybe a couple years ago, and I was like, oh my God, these are actually really good. Again, not healthiest for you, but they're yummy, what can I say? They also have some like fish fillet stuff, which kind of has that like fishy taste as well. So yeah, anything breaded and Gardein, Hi. But these are more expensive. Like, how much were these? How much were these? Each of these was $5.50. So, I mean, it's not terrible, but it's definitely like, you know, like, can of beans is $1, okay? Whereas, like, this one is $5.50, and it's, like, not too big. Like, it's probably, like, two servings, okay? Anyway, I think that's it. Did I show you everything? I think so. So, that is it. This whole thing cost me around, yeah, just a little over $80 Canadian. This whole thing, which is a little more than I would expect, but it's because I got quite a few kind of like substitutes, like the yogurt. I think this was like around $6 or something. So the yogurt was about $6. We also got like the giant, you know, bulk supply of Frank's hot sauce. I got quite a few little substitutes. So yeah, it is a little bit more expensive than my usual grocery hauls, but that's why, okay? So that's how you can tell that, you know, buying a lot of substitutes is gonna obviously rack up the grocery bill because you are buying lots of substitutes. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure you check out my other grocery hauls if you enjoyed this one. I'll link the playlist down below so you can see more cheaper grocery hauls as well. And if you found this helpful, do let me know, and maybe I'll keep trying to do these as, you know, I remember them. So that's it. Hope you guys enjoyed. Give it a big thumbs up if you did. And of course, if you are new to this channel, don't forget to subscribe. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!